this is not here, but 2z here. And then because we have canceled this one, this is equal minus 0 in the z axis. So this gives us that our x component is equal to 4z square minus 2x in the x direction and plus 2z in the z direction. This is del cross v here, and now the area element means this area that we have inside this square, means the area of this square is equal to this area is equal is I'm going this way, this, so it is this area, and this area is then equal in the x unit vector, so it is dy and dz in the x unit vector. So dA here comes out to be dy and dz in the x unit vector. So what about del cross v dot dA, del cross v and dot dA here is equal to multiply the x unit vector with this while the other will give a zero here. So this comes out to be equal to 4z square minus 2x, and then dA is dy and dz here. So this is equal to this, and now I can find for this one, the as I know that along this square the x is equal to 0, x is equal to 0 along this square. So this del cross v dot dA will come out to be 4z square and dy dz. So now I will integrate this one. So it is integral along dy and dz, so y 0 to 1 and z from 0 to 1 is it's a unit square, and I have 4z square dz, and then dy will come in with this. Now it will come out to be 4z cube by 3, so 4 by 3 and z cube, and this is from 0 to 1, and then it will become y from 0 to 1 here. So this is equal to 4 by 3 finally. And z 1 0, so it will come out to be 4 by 3. And now I calculate the faces, the length integral along the faces. So the very first one that I do calculate along the face, then I know it is along means dy is changing, and along this axis we are having x equal to 0 and y is some value and z is equal to 0, y is non-zero while z is equal to 0. So put first write v dot dl. V dot dl, it means that x and z are 0, so dx and dy will be equal to 0. So the dl, the length element, is the length element dl is equal to dx and x plus dy and y and dz and z. So we are having x equal to 0, so dx 0, dy, dz is 0, only dy and y direction is available. So only the y component will be multiplied with this, and it will give us 2xz plus 3y squared. And we know that x is equal to 0 and z is equal to 0, so this comes out to be 3y square dy. X is 0, y is 0, so this is 0 plus 3y square, and the dl will give dy only. So 3y square dy, and now when I integrate this from 0 to 1 and 3y square dy, then it will come out to be y cube over 3. So 3 will cancel and y cube will give us 1. So it is equal to 1 here. And when I consider the part 2, then part 2 is, on part 2, this y is equal to 1 while x is 0. X is equal to 0 while y is equal to 1. And the variation is only occurring along z, and z is non-zero here. So it means that only dz component of this is here while these two are zero. So only the z component will be multiplied, and it is 4yz square. So v dot dl will come out to be 4yz square and dz here. But I know that y is equal to 1, so it will make this thing equal to 4z square dz, because y is equal to 1. This implies now the integral will be from 0 to 1 and 4z square dz here, and this is equal to, it will become z cube over 3. So 4 over 3 z cube from 0 to 1, and this comes out to be 4 over 3. And now the third phase, the third line, will give us the third path. We know that on a third path the z value is equal to 1 while the variation is occurring along y, and x is equal to 0. So x is again equal to 0 here while the variation is, means z is equal to 1 and y is non-zero, it is varying. So it is the dy component only of this, and v dot dl will give us only the y component. And here this is the y component, and this is 2xz plus 3y squared. So x is equal to 0 here, so this component is gone, and we are left only with 3y square in dy. So 3y square dy here, and now we will integrate this one. So this implies, now the integral is not from 1, from 0 to 1, but from 1 to 0, because y value is 1 here and here is 0. So it is from 1 to 0, and 3y square dy here, and it will come out to be y cube over 3, and 3 will cancel, so 1, and y will give you minus 1 because it is from 0 to 1. So we are having the result is minus 1. And what about the fourth phase, the fourth line, not the phase, but the fourth line will give us, on this line z is changing while x and y are equal to 0. So x is 0, x is equal to 0, y is equal to 0, and z is changing, z is not 0. So only dz component will retain, and v dot dl will give us only the dz component. So here dz multiplied with this 4y square, 4yz square, yz squared dz. But we know that y is equal to 0, so it means this thing is equal to 0 and its integral will be equal to 0. So we got our four components here along the line integral on this square, and they come out to be equal to the very first one. The very first one comes out to be means the first face that I have calculated, and I calculated over here, and this came out to be 1 here. So I have 1, and then plus the second came out to be 4/3, while the third came out to be -1, and the fourth came out to be 0. And this is equal, the 1 are going to cancel here, and then I am left with only 4/3. And I can see here that 4/3 is here the result of the line integral, and here 4/3 is the result of the surface integral. So both results are the same. It means the right hand side, the left hand side is equal to the right hand side. So it is the same thing. If you take a quantity here and calculate the curl of that quantity and then calculate the flux of that quantity on a given surface, the flux of that quantity, the flux of the curl of that quantity, and it is the same thing if you go around the boundary of it, means the path integral, so the result will be the same. And this is the fundamental theorem for gradient. I will suggest you that if you would have understood this thing, then you are supposed to solve the problem 1.33, the problem 1.33 and problem 1.34. They are relevant to this topic. Although in one we are having one kind of geometry, while in the other we are having the other geometry. So I will suggest you solve those problems, and this will increase your understanding. With the help of the Stokes theorem, we will then prove some Maxwell equations with the theorem, the Green's theorem or the divergence theorem, and the curl theorem. We will prove some Maxwell equations. They are helpful in converting from the differential to the integral form, or from the integral form through to the differential form. So they will be helpful for doing those conversions, and I hope you would have understood them. In the next lecture, we will go to the coordinate systems, the curvilinear coordinate systems. We will cover the Cartesian coordinate system, and then we will cover the plane polar coordinate system, then the spherical polar coordinate system, and cylindrical polar coordinate system. So stay tuned for those lectures as well. Thank you.